A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 10th Feb, on the front page you have Jammu and Kashmir administration offers investors uninterrupted internet Wi-Fi access. So IT policy document of J&K administration highlights low crime, clean air in the Indian territory. So here we can see civilians are not given access to internet, but investors who come to Jammu and Kashmir would be given. This is new coronavirus toll hits 811 as China gears up to reopen offices and schools. So new coronavirus has already taken lives of 811 people. There had been almost a shutdown in China, but now it has decided to reopen offices and schools. White collar employees can work from home, and facilities have been established which are more than what we had during SARS epidemic in China in 2002. On page 3, you have country's first darknet narcotics operative held. So this is by Narcotics Control Bureau. It has arrested the country's first narcotics operative through the darknet. He allegedly shipped hundreds of psychotropic drugs parcels abroad in the garb of sex stimulation medicines. So he's a 21-year-old son of a retired army officer, and he has been arrested by Narcotics Control Bureau. The payment gateways of cryptocurrencies were used by the operators to conceal the transactions from regulatory agencies. On page 6, you have only 82 trafficking survivors awarded relief in last 8 years. So this is National Crime Records Bureau report, which shows that the total number of cases of human trafficking are 35,983. These are official figures. Actual figures may be much more. So this is a figure between 2011 and 2018. But if you look at the number of trafficking survivors who have been awarded relief in these last 8 years, it is only 82. So this has been revealed through an RTI query. So we know after 2012, Nirbhaya Fund has been established after the Nirbhaya gang rape case. So this Nirbhaya Fund has been used in victim compensation scheme also, which is a national scheme to compensate survivors of rape, acid burns and trafficking. And for the last few years, this has been used, but the amount of compensation to victims of trafficking is quite low. So Supreme Court had also in 2018 directed NALSA, National Legal Services Authority, to frame a standardized victim compensation scheme. But the situation is not up to the mark, we can see. Even District Legal Services Authority and State Legal Services Authority's response to the claims has been slow, compensation claims. And they hold the survivors' claims with suspicion, often putting the burden of proof on the survivors themselves. So, trafficking survivors have not been compensated. On page 8, you have bond rule in Bengaluru draws fire. So, several organizations which are up in arms against Bengaluru police's decision to have them sign indemnity bond of up to 10 lakh as a precondition for permission to stage protests are planning to challenge this in the court. So this has been criticized as a clampdown on the fundamental right of legitimate and peaceful assembly and dissent. Then below you have DRDO chief bats for indigenous technology. So the government wants to increase indigenous production of defense sector up to 70% and reduce imports. So DRDO chairman also, Mr. Reddy, also has been pushing for this. Electric scooter has also been launched by a startup incubated at IIT Hyderabad. So here you can see Niti Aayog and the DRDO chief together launched this e-Pluto 7G vehicle by pure EV. So this was done in the premises of IIT Hyderabad. So it's an electric vehicle. Then here you have Kerala mulls vigilant cell for health. So, Kerala government is reportedly mulling over a proposal to set up a vigilance wing in the health department. So, this wing will monitor private practice by doctors and crack down on quackery. On page 9, you have a record in West Bengal Madrasa exam. So, close to 18% of the 70,000 students who are expected to take school leaving exam from this West Bengal Madrasa are Hindus. So, the school completely follows the secondary education board syllabus of the state government. On the editorial page, the first editorial is searching for a solution. So, this is regarding the Bodo Accord, which has been signed, the third Bodo Accord, which was in news. So this new accord empowers Bodos, but questions about enduring peace remain, that whether peace would prevail for a long time. So the demand for Bodo land, which has been there, so Bodo land territorial region has been established, renaming has been done, 1500 crore development package has been provided to the population here, so that militants here give up arms. Then this is cat conundrum. So this is regarding cheetahs. So it says India misses its cheetahs, but the priority, cheetahs have gone extinct in the country, but it is said the priority must be to preserve the existing species rather than bringing new species. We are talking of bringing cheetahs from Namibia and in Madhya Pradesh, in the Kuno National Park in Madhya Pradesh. So these African cheetahs being brought here. So what is being stated is that the existing species should be preserved, because even incorporation of cheetahs would have effect on other species which are there, like Kuno. It also has tiger population, so that is a concern. And it's a long pending plan which has been rejected on various grounds too, and now again it has been revived, in reintroduction of cheetahs in India. Then the lead article is A Nation for the Persecuted. So this is regarding Rohingyas. So it says India's dismal treatment of the Rohingya must lead to a movement for an inclusive state with an acceptable refugee law. So the way we have treated the Rohingyas too, the Rohingyas have been settled in camps in Bangladesh. The Cox Bazar camp is the largest such camp in Bangladesh, while India has not been welcoming for Rohingyas. So our refugee policy is also being questioned. Even claims have been made that this is against international conventions too, that a persecuted population comes to the country and they are being sent back to the country from where they have come. We have sent them back to Myanmar, where even the UN has stated that the situation is not conducive for them to return. It's a threat to their life. And this is victim justice is a two-step forward, one step back. So this article talks of how victim participation needs to be strengthened by providing private counsels with a greater say in the trial conduct. So how victims can be part, efficiently be part of the trial, that is being spoken of. And op-ed page you have, seeking a more progressive abortion law. So this is regarding medical termination of pregnancy bill. So this bill of 2020, the amendment bill we saw, will be tabled in parliament soon. It has been approved by the cabinet. So this bill seeks to amend the original act of 1971. Earlier two attempts have been made, but bills have lapsed. This bill also seeks to enhance the period up to which even termination of medical termination of pregnancy can be allowed. But that is for women in distress, not for women who have found. You can see legal abortion will be increased from 20 to 24 weeks for specific categories of women, like survivors of rape, victims of incest, etc. But women who have seen significant fetal defect, they would not be given this relaxation. So criticism has come forth on that aspect too. So other concerns with the Medical Termination of Pregnancy Act are also discussed here. And this is Malawi at the crossroads. So this is regarding the annulment of May 2019 presidential elections of Malawi's constitutional court. So this annulment by Malawi's constitutional court could have far-reaching consequences for the continent's democratic process. So there have been many controversies with respect to elections and democracy in African continent. So these rulings as such in Malawi and even in another nation here, you can see, have created a positive environment that democracy can still prevail in the region. On page 12 you have India-Bangladesh rail link to be ready by 2021. So this is landmark rail line which will connect the northeastern region of India with Bangladesh. So this is called Agartala-Akhwara. Agartala in Tripura and Akhwara in Bangladesh, they would be linked by this rail line. So this is the first train to run from northeastern region to Bangladesh. So this will happen on the, this will be completed by 2021 on the eve of 75th anniversary of India's independence in 2022. And this is Kaveri Delta to be declared a protected agriculture zone. So this is regarding a region in Tamil Nadu, Kaveri Delta region. So this is the step being taken by the state government to ensure food security of the state. So we had seen government came up with a notification of mining being allowed, exploration, hydrocarbon exploration, being allowed in any region without any environment impact assessment or consultation with the population. So this had raised concerns in Kaveri Delta, where already protests were going on against such acts. So this relaxation by the central government has raised concerns. And now state government says we'll declare this region as a protected special agricultural zone. And this is fourfold jump in lithium ion battery imports since 2016. So this is what government has told the Lok Sabha. So India lacks manufacturing capability and is the world's largest importer of batteries. These lithium ion batteries are used in many electronics, in electric vehicles, even in cell phones, etc. So Transfer of Technology MOU has also been, Memorandum of Agreement has also been signed in 2018, but we need to do more. China dominates the lithium ion battery market. On page 13, you have this interview with Prime Minister of Bhutan. Bhutan is a country which is known for giving priority, top priority to environment. And then here you have no tally of government buildings to be made accessible. So this is regarding Accessible India campaign. It has been 4 years since it was launched to make public offices, transport and websites accessible to persons with disabilities. But it has been seen that work has not been done as such to a satisfactory extent. And this is government wraps US agency for Nipah work. So this is the Center for Disease Control and Prevention. So it has funded training at Manipal laboratory without health ministry's clearance. So this is US government body, CDC, Center for Disease Control and Prevention. So Indian government has censured it, saying that it funded training without health ministry clearance. So this was work on Nipah virus, which was considered as a potential bioweapon. And this is Orisha plans projects in Naxal stronghold. So this is Swabhiman Achal, which is a stronghold of CPI Maoist in Orisha's Malkangiri district. So state government has lined up development projects, including livelihood programs, irrigation facilities, critical road networks for the region. So the region remains backward due to poor connectivity and hilly terrain. So government is now initiating projects here in the Naxal stronghold. On international page, you have thousands on cruise ship disembark after tests. So this is, you can see the passengers disembarking from the World Dream in Hong Kong. This is was a cruise ship. 3,600 were quarantined on board for 5 days over fears that some staff could have contracted the virus. So this is regarding new coronavirus only. Then on Mondays, you have on business page a money wise coverage, which is individual investments related news which comes first. So this can be skipped. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashara.com. Thank you.